guys, how's everybody doing? So today I would like to take this opportunity to invite you to a class that I'll be teaching on our virtual wellness studio. It's called Village Well. So it'll be this Sunday at 4 p.m. It's going to be a 90-minute master class, 4 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, that is. And so this class I've titled Body's Wisdom, and what I'm going to explore in this particular offering is really guiding people in such a way that they can use their own intuitive movements and having a little bit more freedom within each and every pose to find what works for their specific body needs. In all my years of teaching, which is almost 15 years now, I've studied almost every different modality of yoga variety that you know that's out there, from Bikram to more traditional vinyasa to Anusara, and then to the bowspring alignment. And so I found working, you know, specifically with my clients who have, you know, needs as far as therapeutic applications and benefits, working one-on-one, that as much as I may have an idea of what, you know, a template may provide, I still have to really find and help them find what works for them specifically. And I think that's really important when we are practicing yoga, that we have to be able to feel into our bodies, into our practice, and know what really works for us. So I'm just gonna kind of show you a couple little moves here just to give you an idea of what I'm talking about. So to begin, seated as I am here, and this particular cross-legged variation is not always the easiest pose for everybody to access. So you're welcome to prop yourself with like a bolster or a pillow, just a block, a yoga block, a little bit of a support if you need to just help with maybe the tightness of the hips. And another thing that you can do is even prop under the outer thighs if that gives you a little bit more support. So I'll come into a seated position. And then to start, I'm just gonna bring my hands to my base thighs and just start moving a little bit freely through my ribs and start to release through my neck and my shoulders. And then bringing the arms into the mix, you can move the fingers, the wrists a bit. And so we can just start exploring and letting the body move in the way that it wishes to. So yes, we're always gonna have an alignment, a form that we can really move with as far as keeping our ribs full, our belly long, and muscle tone, and so on. But at the same time, we want to have some freedom in the practice to explore the movements and listen to the body's guidance and really what it wishes to do, so that we're not constantly being held to a specific form, which can be a bit confining and restraining. Extend and lengthen. And then touching down to the earth, I'm gonna come to all fours. And so once I come to all fours, same thing, I'm just gonna let myself move a little bit. Exploring the movements, keeping a focus on the center of the heart and the ribs so that there is a buoyancy and a lightness. I'm gonna let myself just move and explore, opening the neck and the shoulders. Keeping a tone of the belly, and then we can glide the hips back, just broadening through the pelvic floor, and then bring the shoulders forward to surpass the wrists, focusing on a little bit of a tone of the belly. But all the time in this, you're allowed to pulse and move and explore and listen to your own body and let it have some freedom for creative expression. Curl the toes under and then lift the hips. Bend the knees a bit, and then you can start with some more pulsing movements. Twisting, toes to the right, heels to the left. And to center, another direction. So again, letting ourselves just move a little bit in each and every pose. Coming back to center. Lowering to all fours. Kick the left foot out and step with the right. And then I go back with my thighs. I'm gonna start to move a little bit through the hips. Try our let yourself unfurl.
It's exploring movement. The hips back, ribs buoyant, curl back. And your knees to touch. Come back all fours. Kick the right foot out, and step with the left. Go way back with your hips. So instead of just cueing every movement, it's allowing the practitioner, the student, to move a little bit how they want. Letting there be some freedom for creative expression. And listening and having a deeper, more intimate relationship with your body. Curl the toes under, lift up once again, step the feet wide, walk the hands back, and just let yourself move here. The knees will push forward a bit and the thighs go back. Inhaling, length. Exhaling as you fold. Placing the hands, rising up. Stand, stepping neutral, and then a little standing stretch, just moving the body a bit. We want to honor the curves that form the wavy formation in the practice, which is really important for functional movement, health of joints, stability, uniform tone, and so forth. But at the same time, let yourself just move. Now, again, it doesn't have to be anything specific, it's just really listening into your own body. And stepping wide. And slowly begin to descend. Touching down. And I'm just going to come to a seat. So, studying all these different types of practices, I love alignment-based yoga. I think it's important therapeutically for people, but I also think that we need a nice balance where we need to have a little bit of fluidity and freedom so we're not too rigid. I remember that learning to surf when one of my surf instructors said to me, you know, like I was too much alignment based. I was too much following the form. And he's like, just let yourself have a little bit of sensing and freedom so that you're not so tight and rigid. And there's a lot of truth to that, and I think that's true in our practice. And also listening to ourselves. We are sovereign over our experience. We are the captains of our ship. So we have to take a bit of accountability as what feels good. You know, it's if someone's telling you to do this, that, or the other, but it doesn't feel good in your body, then you need to start exploring what does feel good, what is nurturing, what is supportive. So again, Village Well, I'll add the link here for you. It's gonna be this Sunday, 4 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, 90-minute practice. And we have some really great offerings on this virtual wellness studio, great instructors, and I'd love to have some of you guys that are on my YouTube, subscribers, check it out and see what we have to offer. It's very reasonably priced. And love to have you. Thank you guys so very much, and I'm gonna have more videos coming as you've requested. So the first one is the beach practice. So thank you, and I hope you all have a beautiful, blessed day wherever you are. Stay safe, stay healthy. From my heart to yours, I bow. And have a wonderful day. Pura vida and aloha. Ciao.